In this video, I'm going to take a look at this Viltrox 24mm F1.8 fast wide-angle lens. Hi guys, my name is Matti Sulanto and I'm a photographer. And in this video, we're gonna take a look at this Viltrox 24mm F1.8 fast wide-angle lens. But first, a disclaimer, I did not buy this lens. Viltrox sent this lens to me and that's why I have to have the paid promotion label down there. But this is not a paid advertisement or anything like that. And everything I'm going to say is my own opinion. And indeed, it is my opinion, only one person's opinion. So if you get interested and if you wish to buy this lens, please also check at least one more review on this same product to get more balanced view on this lens. Viltrox has been making lenses for some time now, but I think they have been progressing quite fast and it seems like they are coming up with a new autofocus lens very often these days. This lens is their 24mm F1.8 fast wide angle lens for full frame cameras. And the available mounts are so the Sony mount, which I'm using, or this lens is for the Sony, and the other available mount is Nikon Z, which is a small surprise. But lucky for Nikon users also that they have this option if they wish to use this option. The build quality feels quite decent actually, and it feels like most of the materials, exterior materials, are metal. Not that metal would be any better necessarily than high quality plastic or composite, but metal construction always feels like, you know, a little bit better than plastic. The only thing that feels a little bit cheap is the aperture ring. I like that there is the ring, but it feels a little bit cheap. There are no clicks and it makes this, I hope you can hear it, this slightly like grinding abrasive noise when you turn the ring, and it just doesn't feel very premium. And I think, as a matter of fact, I think it is actually cheaper to build it like this, because then you don't have to design any kind of a click mechanism into the lens. I wish they used clicks, because that would be so much nicer for photography. But anyway, other than that, it feels like a very decent lens mechanically. Viltrox doesn't claim any kind of weather sealing, and also when you look around the mount, there is no seal or rubber gasket there. I used this lens in minus 12 centigrade or Celsius for about 2 hours without any issues. I didn't use this lens in any kind of snowfall or rain. So I don't know what would happen if I would do that, but anyway, officially no weather sealing whatsoever. And talking about the mount, there is a USB connector in the mount, and you can use that to update the firmware. First you go to Viltrox website, download the file, then you connect this to your computer with a cable and the lens appears as an external drive. Then you just drag and drop the firmware file on the lens that appears as an external drive, and you're good to go. Very fast, easy and convenient. In my opinion, this is quite compact for what it is, but this is a relatively fast 24mm lens, so this can't be really tiny. The filter size is 55mm and this weighs in this E-mount version just over 360 grams with the included hood. And I like that the hood is included. This balances really well on the Sony A7C, which is my camera, and the aperture ring, which I already mentioned, is great for ergonomics, especially on the Sony A7C, which only has one proper command dial. But I'm pretty sure this would balance really well also on all other Sony full-frame cameras and also on Nikon full-frame cameras. And of course, you can move the aperture ring to the A position, so you can control your aperture from your camera, if that is what you prefer. This lens has no optical stabilizer, so you are going to rely entirely on your camera's IBIS, which should be no problem, because this is a wide-angle lens and relatively easy for the camera's stabilization system, even on the Sony A7C, which doesn't have the greatest stabilizer on the market. And then about the optical performance, which in short is really impressive in my opinion, at least on my 24 megapixel camera. But it's so solid that I have no doubt that this lens wouldn't perform on higher megapixel camera also. The sharpness is really good, already wide open, even in the corners, which was a little bit surprising, I have to admit that. It gets a little bit better when you stop down just a little bit, as it always does, and the sweet spot is typically for a full frame lens from about f4 to f8 or so. But even f16 looks quite decent in my opinion, no major signs of diffraction visible. There is some vignetting visible wide open, not a surprise. How pronounced it is, it depends a little bit on what you are shooting. If you have a lot of sky, for example, then it looks more pronounced than in some other scenarios. To my eyes, it never looked distracting or anything. And if you find it distracting, just stop down a couple of stops and it's gone. And then about the distortions. They are, of course, auto-corrected in camera, and for example Lightroom, which is my preferred application, applies the corrections automatically. So from now on I have decided not to pay any attention to distortions, because that's how most people see them anyway, auto-corrected. And if there's nothing suspicious going on in the final pictures, then I think it's just fine. And most mirrorless lenses are like that. And that's the way optical design is these days. And I know some people don't like it. I think it's fine. But if you're shooting mirrorless, then you better get used to it, because that type of optical design is here to stay. So no distortions visible with this lens. I can't see any lateral chromatic aberrations, but I can see some longitudinal chromatic aberrations. However, I never found them distracting or anything, but in some situations you can definitely see them if you look closely. I think this lens handles backlight really well. There were a couple of sunny days during my testing and I could not see any serious flare or reflections in my pictures, no matter how I tried. And I was actually a little bit surprised how well this lens handles backlight. And then about the bokeh. A wide angle is never your, you know, your really mean bokeh machine, but at the wide open f1.8 aperture and at relatively close focusing distance, you can certainly create a soft background, and the bokeh, in my opinion, looks reasonably pleasant. It's not the best, smoothest bokeh I have ever seen, but it looks reasonably decent anyway. And then the autofocus, which is quite good. If we have a scale from 0 to 10, where 0 is the worst possible lens, struggles, is noisy and all that, and 10 is the best first party lens, on that scale this lens would be probably about 8, which is to say very good in most scenarios. This is not quite as fast as the fastest first party lenses, and you may see it struggles sometimes in some rare occasions, but I would say the autofocus for photography works in general really, really well. And now let me switch this lens on my Sony A7C and we're gonna make a short, quick video autofocus test. All right, now the Viltrox 24mm is mounted on my Sony A7C camera and let's see how the autofocus can follow my face when I'm moving around a little bit. What about the focus breathing? Let's focus close and then a little bit further away. I think the focus breathing is quite mild on this lens, which is also good. And all in all, I think the autofocus seems to perform quite well. What do you think? The minimum focusing distance is 0.3 meters, which is nothing really that special. And this lens is not especially good for close-ups, but then again, most wide angles are like that. I was a little bit impressed by this lens. I really like the optical characteristics, and I think this is a pretty good value for money. The only minor downsides are the cheap feeling aperture ring and no weather sealing. But if you are looking for a relatively affordable, fast wide angle for your Sony or Nikon full frame mirrorless, I think this Viltrox 24 F1.8 is worth a look. And by the way, here is one video that I filmed on this lens, just in case you want to see a little bit longer video autofocus test. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.